task before they got to work exploring. The previous day, they had broken a rover fender of the rover. The dust thrown up was causing trouble. A Brother 16 commander, John Young, had worked that night in a pressure suit on the way to fix the fender. On the moon, the astronauts put it together. The fender section flew from a lower map loaded with tape, then held in place with clamps from a lower module telescope. It was a repair that would last the remainder of the mission. Then Schmitt moved out to place one of several explosive packages which would be detonated after they left the moon, mapping the lower subsurface, much as earthly geologists explore for oil. Someone would pick him up in the rover with a drive to the first site on this traverse, Station 2.
They're somewhere along this rim where they can see.
But they're dropping, Bill, so they must be coming upon it.
We're right where we wanted to be for Station 2. It looks like a great place. Down the line, there looks like quite a bit of variety from here. Different colors, anyway. Pretty hard, isn't it? I'm bored with it. Man, it is horrible. It's not
self control. The foreground features are somewhat different. I didn't feel they were farther up under the hill, I think. That's otherwise, that's remarkable.
Sorry, it's not even very, very cohesive. Because it's the bottom of the core is not smooth, it's very jaggedy and very metal-like.
Gene's finished with the core two, then we should be able to go.
If we get that thing up.
Several locations on this EVA, but none would cause more excitement than the find of a critter called Shorty.
Oh, hey! There he is, boring soil! Well, don't move it till I see it. It's all over! Orange! Don't move it till I see it. I'm straight up with my feet. There it is! I can see it from here! It's orange! Fantastic, sports fans. It's trench time. Yeah, that is very large.
I think it's pretty exciting. We were all talking about since the beginning of the program. It even is going to be the most demanding of all these time zones.
System is going to be designed so that all of the costed parts are reusable. Now that we're beginning to understand space, we begin to understand the potential, the economic potential, the need is to bring larger arrays of instrumentation up in space, the need to provide man with a real capability to work up in space.
Okay, Bob, I'm out of pad. Pad, about 4:30, Wednesday afternoon. As I step out, I'm on a plane to tourist withdrawal. Beautiful valley.
December 13th. Yesterday, they had explored the south end of the valley. Today, they will go north.
This is the last time for you to really go to the bathroom.
Sunday, we have a good flight.
Holy smiley! Why are we on a boat? You okay?
Man, that's rough country in here.
The promise science will continue, and I'm sure much of the mysteries will continue to come out for many years to come.
But of this I'm sure, man has learned that space is his to explore, and man will return to space to explore, to the moon and beyond.
I'm firmly convinced that it's changed the whole basis of philosophy, including religion. I don't think that we've begun to see what the era of spaceflight really is. We've got a long way to go, and I hope I'm living when we leave this solar system on a venture to find another planet Earth.
Schmitt returned to the rover to drive back to Challenger. But before they left the surface of the moon, they had a very brief ceremony. Experiments bay. In orbit, as on the surface, the seconds are precious.
Take the order.
aged Challenger, rover on the moon, they left a plaque reading, "Here man completed his first explorations of the moon, December 1972 AD. May the spirit of peace in which we came be reflected in the lives of all mankind." One revolution later, Sam and Schmitt caught up with Evans and prepared for docking.
I can see him. You're gonna come back up here. It's been a good trip. Man, that job is a beautiful vehicle. You pick it.
December 16th. Born in Europe and head home to Earth.
You
took
America
and
found
December 17th, 170,000 miles from Earth. Ron Evans left the command module. Evans was retrieving film canisters from the two cameras and the rover sounding radar, data vital to the scientists on Earth. Before we got back inside, Evans took a last look at the crescent Earth. In 2 more days, they would be home. December 19th. He rode inside a 5,000-degree fireball through the atmosphere of Earth, stowed in the spacecraft almost 250 pounds of the moon.
Chapter in the age of space exploration. In a way, it brings a close to what has been a very romantic era in space exploration. But, someone who takes it very strong, the book is still being written.
A lonely world in the absence of man. But here we have left our mark, a signature attesting a legacy to future generations. We stood on the shoulders of giants and touched the moon.